Austin's home prices from July to August 2021 dropped over 6%. Here's what you must know. Jeremy Knight, The Knight Group, your favorite Austin realtor. I think what you're going to see here is a lot of people start saying that this is the reason or this is the justification of why they've been saying the market's going to crash. But let's look at the data. Let's look at the information because there's some good information here and there's some concerning information as well. So first off, make sure you drop a comment. I want to hear from you. Is this the end? Is the market dropping? Is it crashing? Is it seasonal? What do you think it is? Let's hear from you in the comments below. Okay, so what I found funny is that when we did get the email out from ABOR, that this was their heading, keep calm and carry on. Despite 4% decrease in home sales in the Round Rock MSA, the region's housing market remains atop of the U.S. market. Okay, so here is the data right here. If we're looking for just the city of Austin, we went from almost a 575 price in July, all the way down to 540, which is a little over 6% decrease. Now, most agents, when they look at this, all they see is the 27% increase from year over year, but it's really important to look at the month over month as well. This also follows that chart that I actually showed you a few times in my videos, where July's numbers start to top out and then drop down in August. This is also partly why I tell most of my clients that buying, the best time to buy really is between late July through the beginning of November because prices do flatten out and come down a little bit. But this is a pretty big jump. You know, 6.8% is not something that's really small. It is a significant number. So let's take a look at this. Yes, so we're looking at days on market did jump up about from 12 days to 15 days. We're also looking at the inventory stayed the same, 0.9 months inventory. And this is gonna be the big key factor for a lot of these people that keep saying the market's about to pop, is that inventory is still low. In other videos, we showed that the inventory for this time in 2019 was about 2.7 months. And then if we look at 2020, about 1.7, 1.4, and about 1.2 months inventory, respective to these months that we're in right now. We are still lower than 2020's numbers, and I think that's something that's gonna carry through the end of the year. If you look at the MSA, yeah, it was about 4% drop, but if we look at the MSA, if we look in June to July, the price has dropped about $2,000. They're still up over last year's numbers. And then if we look July to August, it dropped about 10,000, which is about like, you know, 2%. So it really didn't drop too significantly the MSA, the larger area, and days on market did go up, you know, 2 days. So I think one of the problems that we've seen in the market is that the days on market has been relatively low. And right now buyers do have a little bit better time where they don't have to rush right an offer on a contract. When I went through the data, there's also some really good information in here that I like to look at. If we look at the new construction close numbers, it showed like the median was 476. If we look at the July median numbers, the median numbers was actually 607. That is a pretty significant drop in the new construction market. Now, I think there's some things that play with the new construction market that we're going to see start playing out through the rest of the year. And that's this. A lot of buyers started flooding the market really like July of last year, June, July of last year. And based on the 2020 numbers, our sales prices for the Round Rock MSA stayed pretty consistent. In fact, July 353 to 355 to 355. Austin actually saw July 423 to 435 and then dropped down to 415. So this end of year drop down isn't new. This was about 4.8%, you know, and if we go back and look at 2019 was about a 2.5 to 2.8% drop. So we saw a 2.8% drop in 2019, this time of year. In 2020, we saw about a 4.8 and now we're 6.8. And I think the reason for that is that prices have jumped up so significantly this year that you're gonna see a bigger drop. They were much higher than in 2020 over 2019. In 2021, they're much higher. So I think you're seeing that kind of light correction, not crash. But going back to the new build thing that I was talking about, here's my concern about new builds. About this time last year, a lot of buyers were jumping in the market on new construction. Those homes have not really started closing until now. And so what we're seeing in some of this new construction market is the fact that people put these homes under contract July of last year, and now they're closing right now. So what we're seeing is last year's prices on this new construction start to close now. And so that is gonna probably carry through the rest of the year where our new home prices aren't as high as what they were closing recently. And so that's going to be of concern. So wouldn't you say to me, Jeremy, but wouldn't the June numbers be showing up now? Wouldn't the numbers before that be showing up now as well? Part of that. And I have to say yes and no. You know, some of these builds are about 6 to 8 months builds. So I think a lot of that inventory is already closed that was earlier. And we started seeing a lot more delays towards the end of the year. So that's why that 6 to 8 month that would have closed a couple months ago is now starting to close now. And I think that's one reason. What some of these builders also started doing around that time is starting new build starts, but not putting prices on them until they, and put them as an inventory product. And so they didn't price those products until closer. So I think some of those, what we've seen prior to July, are things that they didn't price until April. And then they, you know, so that's why those prices still went up, because those were priced out in April in the height of some of that lumber cost. So I think that could be one reason. All of these bids started more towards the end of the year, really January, February. And with these new builds closing and people putting $250,000 just for a lot or putting a really high over list price offer, I think what we start seeing at the beginning, the end of this year, the beginning of next year, is we start seeing a lot of appraisal issues for new construction. And we'll probably see another spike up in what closed data looks like for new construction for that reason alone. So when I was looking through the data, what I also did is I went back and looked at the closed sales for July and the closed sales for August to see what if there was a disparity. What I did notice too is that in July, we had about 241 homes, $1 million plus sale. And then if you look at the August numbers, we only saw about 200 million plus sales. That reduction in sales in the $1 million price point is also gonna affect our numbers, because those top end numbers are gonna bring down our median. So I think that's another reason why we saw this big $35,000 drop in prices. One other thing to look at is if you go back and look at the 2020 numbers for the MSA, you know, we saw pretty much a same month over month pricing. And then November, we saw a higher close price. And that goes back to what I've been saying about November. That first like couple weeks in November, there was very little inventory. In fact, if you look, October went from 1.1 months down to 0.9 months, and then December was 0.6 months. And so I think we'll see that same trend where inventory drops off. And so we'll see a panic buy because people want to close before the end of the year. One thing that does concern me still is the fact that interest rates are rising. As of Friday, we saw interest rates rise. Maybe this flattens out through the end of the year, but I feel like this is what I see every year too. Towards the end of the year, we see interest rates rise towards the end of the year. And with that big uptick on Friday that we saw in interest rates, that could push people back into panic buying between now and the year and more of that FOMO. But keep in mind, we only have 0.9 months inventory. And so we really need to see more of that inventory come up for prices to really continue to drop. I'm still not saying that we're gonna see huge price increases next year. What I'm gonna say is that we're gonna see a leveling of prices where we're seeing this 3 to 4%, maybe 6% increases versus these huge 37% increases. So people are probably gonna ask, Jeremy, why do you think prices aren't gonna go dramatically lower or dramatically higher? And I think it's because still we have to look at the amount of people moving here. Now, there's people out there saying that agents are lying to you when they say the amount of people moving here is the reason why prices are increasing. Now, I'm not saying it's the sole reason prices are increasing, but that same person didn't tell you that that data that they had only went through July of 2020. It didn't even 2021. In fact, this information right here shows that we saw 67,000 people move here through July of 2020. Now, if we look at the numbers now, the estimates about 75,000 people have moved since then. So July 2020 to July 2021 is about 75,000 people. So in that area, which is still a big jump in people moving here. I'm not saying it's the sole reason prices are increasing. I think inventory has a lot to do with it, and interest rates as well. Here's the other thing that people really need to keep in mind about the Austin market. We do still have a lot of jobs moving here, like right here. Army Futures Fund still coming here. HEB, GM, all of these people are moving here. This chart right here just shows you all of the businesses that came here in 2021. And if you look what's coming here over the next couple of years, you still have potentially Samsung coming here, but Apple, Tesla still coming here, Google, BAE. So there's still a lot of jobs that are still coming here. I think that's one thing that people who are saying the market's going to burst or pop or whatever, they're really not taking into account the amount of people that are still actually moving here for good paying jobs. The other justification for why people are saying it's going to crash is the fact that, you know, incomes aren't coming up. Well, even the census data stops in 2019. If we look at the stats from the Austin Chamber of Commerce, it actually shows that incomes are around $99,000 household income, which is still a lot, and it's higher than most of the US. So these are all the reasons why I'm still saying that I just don't see a crash coming. Now, I could be wrong. I could absolutely be wrong. I think a lot of investors are going to be back in the market. A lot of these people that are seeing this huge drop that have been waiting on the sidelines for FHA, not putting down 25, 20%, they are going to have a little bit of flexibility now between now and the end of the year, but inventory is still very low. So what do you think? Jeremy Knight, the Knight Group, am I completely off basis? Am I one of those people who are just a crash denier? It's not going to happen. What do you think? Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. We'll see you on the next video.